the National Football League on EA Sports. And the spotlight is on Justin Herbert as he's moved past 3,000 yards passing for the year and looking for more. It's the Chargers and the Rams on Sunday Night Primetime.
Night beginning to fall over Southern California, but the lights are shining bright here at the spectacular SoFi Stadium in metropolitan Los Angeles. Tonight, we've got a great Sunday night matchup between the Los Angeles
through the tape. I thought they looked pretty good last week. It was a solid win, a comprehensive win.
Meanwhile, for the visiting Rams, they're hitting their stride of late. Winners of three of their last four.
And this coaching staff has to be pleased with how their defense played last week. They held their opponents to 3 points, and that was it. If they get anything comparable to that performance, this one's in the bag.
Dustin Hopkins about set to get us started, and off we go from SoFi Stadium. Taken in at the three. And beyond the 20, but not by much. In fact, just a yard pass there to the 21. So out come the Rams now for their first possession. They'll be led out by last year's Super Bowl champion QB in his 14th NFL season now out of Georgia, Matthew Stafford.
A seasoned veteran, we're seeing more chapters being added in Stafford's decorated career. Secured a Super Bowl ring, remains a respected leader, and his stats, they're better than ever. Now we just continue to watch him climb the ranks of the NFL's all-time passing leaders.
On first down, they'll start out with Akers. And he's going to take this ahead for right around 3 yards, but no more than that. Second down. These are his numbers from last week's contest. 23 carries, 53 yards.
Not a horrendous week last week running the ball, but definitely room for improvement for their numbers. No doubt, they made some slight adjustments how they're going to call plays this week in hopes they can kick those numbers up a notch.
And this will be a gain of 5 as he gets it to the 30. An early test, 2 plays in. This is 3rd and 2. They'll try and run for the Israel Lakers. And he gets it to the 34. Good enough for the first. They're able to convert with a gain of 4. From the 34 now, here's 1st and 10. They'll go again here with Akers. And he is swallowed up right at the line of scrimmage. There was Sebastian Joseph who got him down defensively. So after the run for no gain, here's 2nd and 10. They'll try the air now with Stafford. Firing quickly, but it's incomplete.
Take the block first and get a little bit of space and then come across the middle because in their mind, they're thinking catch the ball and then drop the hammer on the little guys in the secondary.
They're able to drop the hammer. He just dropped the pass. And he is going to have a Rams first down as they're able to get the 3rd down conversion. And he's top 5 in the league in terms of receiving yardage because of plays like that. What have you seen from him on film that you like so much?
Well, I'll strip away everything else and get to what we call the moment of truth.
Akers, he cuts it up. And this is recovered by the Chargers. And without a doubt, not the way they pictured that opening drive unfolding.
No, they were making progress. They weren't exactly in high gear, but they were making a few yards along the way. Now that they've coughed it up, you got to go back to the sidelines and regroup a little bit.
Here are the Chargers ready to go on offense, led by their first-round pick in 2020, the man out of Oregon, Justin Herbert.
That was a solid performance last week, wasn't it? 2 touchdowns, no interceptions, ran the team well, won the ball game. Bottom line, may not have been earth-shattering, but it didn't need to be.
They will get 4 yards here on the first down run, and that'll make it 2nd and 6. The numbers for him from a week ago, 15 carries, 56 yards, and a touchdown.
And they've already clinched a playoff berth, so I'm eager to see how they approach this game because
Some teams' philosophy is to go ahead and get guys out. Other teams' philosophy, continue to do what you're doing best. I expect them to go ahead and use their top guys all the way through this one.
Herbert with a connection to Allen for a Charger first down.
I think that's a big pickup for a first down, because when you run a drag route against zone, you're sometimes asking for trouble because you might run into a defender.
Yeah, well, there they ran into a first down. Executed it to perfection. And all the way in for a Charger touchdown. Austin Eckler with touchdown number 12 on the year. And the Chargers take the early turnover and convert it into an opening touchdown. Start at the 25 as Powell decides against returning it. As the Rams offense comes back out, here is the NFC playoff picture coming into the weekend. And with the final fourth night of games upon us, teams jockeying for position. Some of these games really starting to take enormous importance, as they always do this time of year.
I like how you use Fortnite. That means 2 weeks, if I'm not mistaken.
That does.
But how about exactly what you're talking about? Going down the stretch, how much importance is placed on these games? Look, everyone talks about every game's important. When you get to this time of year, maybe that importance gets quadrupled. And that's where we are right now, to see who can make their last run, their last push to get into the playoffs.
They'll run on first down with Akers. And not able to break away this time, as they're going to stop him right around the line of scrimmage. Officially nothing on that last run. They'll try again, second and 10. Out of the gun, Stafford. Complete, Jefferson the target. And down he goes at the 49, a 3-yard pickup. Now this defense for the Chargers, they were excellent a week ago in that victory over Indianapolis.
And the big difference in the ball game, they're ability to force turnovers, three of them in fact. Being able to take the ball away, give it back to their offense, that's something that's emphasized each and every week, and they carried it out.
Here we go on fourth, Stafford. This one brought in by Jefferson. And he goes down, but not before getting this inside the 25. A big play that time on the catch and run. And they're able to pick up the conversion here on fourth down. After one, 7-0 on EA Sports. The Rams with the football here to begin the second quarter. So after the big play on fourth, here's first and 10. Stafford going to give this to Akers. And he'll get it down this time to the 17. It's a 6-yard pickup, and it gets him to second and 4. Going right back to Akers. And he's eaten up at the line of scrimmage. Might have gotten the yard down to 16. Play number 9 set to come here on the drive at 3rd and 2.
That call makes sense because they've been throwing it well on this drive. And once again, they show passing formation. Showing the shot.
Touchdown, Rams! Van Jefferson. 16-yard touchdown. And the Rams are an extra point away from evening this one up. But not only, Charles, did he beat double coverage to make the catch, and then as soon as he did, locked his gaze upfield and made sure to reach the end zone.
Go grab your dictionary, partner. Look up determination, and his picture is going to pop right up. How about him getting through multiple defenders, finding his way through coverage, and making sure he got to the end zone? That's a big-time play right there.
So all even at 7 now as they kick it away. And there will not be a return here. It's a touchback, and it'll come out to the 25-yard line. The Chargers get set to go here for their second drive. And as these guys enter play in Week 17, we know one thing. They are playoff bound, but they want to win that division title. They told us that is a goal that's been posted in their locker room since day one. They've got the chance to control their own destiny.
And there's nothing more powerful than saying that you won the division, because I know from building a team, when I talk with all the GMs and the player personnel directors, they always talk about to get to the playoffs in the NFL, you have to have a team that's constructed to win your division. Beat those teams first. That's your number one path to getting there, and they can get that done in this game.
2 minutes gone by second quarter. On first down, Justin Herbert. That's caught by his tight end, Gerald Everett. Will go down as a gain of 6, and that will bring up second down. Herbert will give this one to Eckler. And some solid footwork there as he'll take this down to about the 48. Give him 15 yards on that one and a Charger first down. Back to throw here, Herbert. Here for first and 10. Herbert operating from the red zone. And he slides and covers up at the end as he's going to be able to pick up decent yardage. The improv on the scramble there gets him 6, and it'll be second down. Second quarter, 2 minutes to go. Tie ball game. 4 yards remain on second down. Ball on the 10. Herbert now to the sideline, and wow, what a catch there. He doesn't get a lot, but he was able to get the feet down complete. Third and 2, Herbert. And he'll be taken down, but he does have first down. Give him 7 on the tuck and run, and it'll get him a new set of downs. Trying to punch it in with Eckler. And he's into the end zone. Touchdown, Chargers. Austin Eckler, his 11th rushing touchdown on the year. And the Chargers have moved out in front. Hopkins with the extra point. And that's the score, 14-7. So a nice drive put together there. 75 yards and 9 plays. And it's Austin Eckler who finishes things off with a touchdown run. From the end zone, here comes Brandon Powell. And a good effort on the return there. Gets him across the 30, up to the 33. And now out on the field, here comes Los Angeles. And Charles, we'll see what they can do here. Not a ton of time left, but enough certainly to get points out of this drive. And they need them right now because they're trailing.
Yeah, this is exactly why you practice a 2-minute drill all through camp. And at least one practice each week before a game. A minute left, more than enough time to string a few completions together, reach the end zone, and then make that run back to Eckler just a little more animated.
Finding room at midfield, and they're going to have this across midfield and inside the 45. Good work after the catch, going to net him 23 and a first. Throwing a Stafford. And this one right back in the hands of Jefferson. And he's going to be marked down just inside the 35.
And we've seen him have success earlier on with the ball in his hands because he has to get it in space and make a play kind of a receiver. But that time, they closed down quickly and held him to a short game.
And he is out of bounds inside the 30. Now a timeout taken. Perhaps a chance for one more quick play and then another timeout if they hurry. We'll see. McKinnon here, it's complete. And he's going to get this down near the 25. So we've...
All right, we'll bypass the halftime show in favor of returning to this late season game with the teams coming back from the locker rooms here a bit early.
Welcome back. Halftime over. We are ready for quarter number 3 alongside Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gordon.
And we will not see a return to start the half as this will be a touchback.
Out comes the Chargers as they'll go on offense now to start this third quarter. And right now they're saying, hey, let's keep this going. 2 drives, 2 touchdowns.
Yeah, can't ask for a better start than that, can you? I mean, this is the way you practice it. This is the way you rehearse it. But right now, the play calling, they're locked in really well.
Holding offense.
So that time they got the left guard with a hold.
And let's face it, in today's ball, you might have that 330-pound guy you're supposed to clear out of there. You might need a little bit of extra help by grabbing the jersey and trying to ride him out.
Sideline throw, it's complete. And a nice job there of keeping the toes in bounds. Throwing again on second down. And it's complete to the right side of Taylor. And he'll be marked down at the 26 with a gain of 7. They'll come to the line here needing 9 yards to pick up the first. Going to throw on third down with Herbert. He's got it to Williams. And he's going to come up a bit short. He needed to get to the 35 for the first, but he only makes it to the 34. So they'll get 8 out of that completion. And it'll be fourth down. Here's J.K. Scott now. And surprisingly, this is the first punt of the game for either team. A 40-yard punt, 5 yards on the return. And the Rams are going offense here with a first and 10. Stafford and the Rams come up first and 10 at their own 27. He starts with a give to Akers. There to make the tackle, Khalil Mack.
I have to think a major focus of the halftime meetings had to be figuring out how to create space for the running game to get operating.
Well, you pointed out to me at half, seems accurate. That line has struggled to sustain blocks.
Yeah, I would agree with that totally. They've got to focus on staying on their double teams at the first level, make sure that block's secure before they slide off, and try to chip some money at the second level.
On third down, here's a run by Akers. And he'll be touched out here, but not before he does pick up the first. A third down gain of 3 yards, and that'll be enough. So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. Stafford now to throw. And he's got his favorite target again. It's complete. And he'll take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds. That's a gain of 13, first down Rams. A
couple of first downs right in success. They can really use a good drive, and they're off to a fast start here.
So from Charger territory now, here's a first and 10 at the 48-yard line. Got a man open, it's Tyler Higbee. And a 6-yard gain gets him right around the 43. Line of scrimmage, the 43 on second and 4. A shotgun snap for Stafford. He'll get this one complete to Atwell. And he's got some space here. Touchdown!
A strong drive here to lead off this third quarter that has them an extra point away from tying things up.
And partner, this is pretty much what they envisioned when they were sitting there in the locker room thinking about getting things going to start here in the third quarter. Getting out there, a field goal would have been fine, but going ahead and scoring here, an extra point away from tying things up, that's exactly how they drew it up on the board.
Gay is on for the point after. And we've got a good one brewing. We're all knotted up at 14. A drive that time of 6 plays. And the result for the Rams, a touchdown. So all square here in this third quarter as the kick's away. The return man down to a knee, and this will come out to the 25-yard line. Now the Chargers offensive unit ready to see what they can do here. And their lead has evaporated in this third quarter. It's tied once more as they begin with a first and 10. And not much to speak of. Call it a 1-yard gain up to the 26. The run only got a yard. Here's second and 9. Now Herbert with it, looking to pass. And that is incomplete.
As this old brain remembers, when I see 5 wide receivers on the field as a defender, I know the ball's coming out hot. They expected it and got there and popped it free.
Being chased, and he can't find a receiver, and he's brought down.
Finally held down for the first time this game. Multiple defenders in there to drop him.
You've got to have that leverage, don't you? We always talk about low man wins in the running game for an offensive lineman.
versus a defensive lineman, it's essentially the same thing in pass protection. Get lower than that defensive lineman so that you can keep your balance and keep him away from your guy trying to throw the football.
It'll be a 47-yard punt with a net of 40 following a 7-yard return.
And they will take over first and 10.
Getting set to go again, Matthew Stafford trots back onto the field. And he had the touchdown on the last drive, also 4 for 4. Very, very effective. What does he need to do to translate that forward into this drive?
Not think that what he saw in coverages last time is exactly what he's going to get again. He's got to play ahead and start thinking to himself, okay, we just did that. What are they going to take away now? What do we go to as a counter and continue to encourage his offensive line to continue to give him time?
They were really good on the last drive. One quarter remains here on a Sunday night.
This is the National Football League on EA Sports. Back now at SoFi Stadium in Inglewood.
All square, 14 apiece to score as we get ready for the fourth quarter. Throwing on third down, Stafford.
Open man is Atwell, complete. He's got the first down and more.
And he takes this just a few yards shy of the red zone before going out. A big play there on the catch and run. 33 yards.
This is what made the West Coast offense a staple around the NFL in the 80s and 90s. You don't have to push the ball deep downfield to come up with big plays, and there's an example of that right there.
They'll go with Akers here up the middle.
And it's been like this all night long. Nowhere to run as they stack him behind the line.
They'll lose a yard there, and it's second and 11.
From the gun, here's Stafford. Firing quickly here, and that's complete.
Down inside the 10. Touchdown! 2-2 Atwell.
With two touchdowns on the season, both in this game.
And the Rams have broken our tie and have taken a fourth quarter lead.
I know we often laugh, and sometimes we even exalt the guys who are great trash talkers and give us some really funny lines. But the bottom line is absolute production on the field. His second touchdown of the game, and they lead.
And now they'll be looking to their defense to preserve that lead. Extra point by Gay is up and good. And the lead is now 21-14. After the touchdown, it's Gay to kick this one away. And they'll put up the stop sign there as his guys will get it at the 25. Heading back out, the Chargers offense. We get a peek at the playoff picture of the AFC.
And right now they're in that number 2 spot. They would love to hold on to that, but obviously first things first. They want to clinch the division.
And that's what everyone plays for. Win your division first, guarantees you a spot in the playoffs. But still, a nice spot to be in. Not as good as it was when the number 2 seed made a first round bye. That's all changed with the new playoff system. But still, a nice spot to be in.
Running on first down, Eckler. And he'll be brought down at the 48-yard line. Under 4 to go now as the clock runs and they come up on second down.
10 yards on the pickup. It's second.
From the shotgun, here's Herbert. Ebron with it over the middle. And this is going to be another first down as the tackle is going to be made at the Rams 36. 12 yards there as they move the chains. Up the middle with Eckler.
54 yards now on the ground on just 7 carries.
And they really needed to get something going, didn't they? They have punted on the last 2 possessions. The running game starting to come to the front for them, providing a nice pickup there to keep this drive going.
On first and 10, Herbert. To the right side to Eric Ebron. And he'll go out of bounds in the red zone just inside the 20. Short completion, just 4 yards, and it'll be second down. Here's Herbert. To the sideline, wow, what a catch. Doesn't get a lot out of it, but he is able to keep the feet in bounds.
pass is swung out to Eckler. They'll get only a yard out of that, and it'll bring up fourth down. They snap it to Herbert. And it's going to be batted down. It will go the other way with the football. The fourth down play doesn't work for the Chargers. And the Rams are going to take possession of the turnover on downs. So the failure to convert, no doubt, really hurts. But this one's not over. A good chunk of time on the clock and the timeouts.
Yeah, not only do they have the timeouts, as you just noted, they're going to get an extra one with the two-minute warning. And that's going to help them big way. So in a sense, they have four timeouts in their pocket. The big thing, stopping them on defense now. They can't let them get a first down and make them use their timeouts and get a fresh set of downs. They've got to stop them right here. And if so, they've still got an opportunity.
Fourth quarter, down to the final 2 minutes. And we've got a one-score game. So it's Rams football here as we get you reset. This, in all probability, another run here on second and eight. There's Stafford. Throwing middle, and it's complete. And now we'll see a timeout used on defense as they stop it right out of the break with 1:57 to go in the ballgame. Stafford. Over the middle and complete to the tight end, Higbee. And he's brought down short by a yard. It's a third down gain of four. So instead of giving them another third down, they'll decline it.
That penalty is declined.
Now that's smart football right there. You don't even have to really spend a lot of time considering it. Just know that you're probably going to get the ball back. Good job declining that penalty.
They snap it to Stafford. And it's incomplete. They cannot convert. And they turn it over. No luck for the Rams as they fail here on fourth down. And the Chargers will get the football back in excellent field position. Herbert to throw. He'll get this out wide to Eckler. And they'll bring him down at the 18-yard line. Clock running, about to hit 90 seconds to go in the game. That one thrown away from the pocket. The officials kind of looking at each other, but they'll say there was a receiver in the area, so no penalty, just an incomplete pass. Herbert. And that one's going to be knocked away and incomplete.
With that incompletion, reality is staring them right in the face. This entire game is down to the next snap.
They'll run for it with Eckler. And he'll have the first down, getting this one to the 14-yard line. First down now, but that clock rolling. He'll drop this one off to Eckler. And he's going to be marked down just outside the 10. Now Herbert got to get him to the line in a hurry. Herbert going to throw. Looking Austin Eckler's way again. And he's able to work it here to the 8-yard line. They'll get to the line here, but remember, it's also third down. And the comeback may stall out. It's intercepted. And the Rams have just about sewn up this football game.
And Brandon, this is a real nice job defensively of getting inside a quarterback's head and figuring out, okay, where is he going with the football? Because you can make an educated guess defensively, not all the time, but sometimes. And when you're right, you've got a decent chance of coming away with the football.
The offense for Los Angeles returns to the field. And still two timeouts defensively, but even if they choose to use those, three kneel downs should be enough to get out of here with a victory.
And that's exactly what's being stated into the head coach's headset. Oftentimes they have a guy upstairs who monitors this at the end of the game. Their clock management 101.
Now the Chargers will use the second of their timeouts as they get it with 16 seconds remaining on the clock. 8 yards the gain on that last run. Here's second and a couple. They'll run out of the gun with Akers. And they're able to get this one across the 35. Now the defense will burn their third and final timeout. And as the two teams talk it over on their respective sidelines, we take a break.
Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. A give up the middle to Akers. It's a 6-yard gain on the ground, and that'll make it second and four.
Well, that second half, Charles, a little bit different from the first. Not only did we have the lead change after intermission, but they were able to pitch the shutout in the second half and get an impressive victory.
And what's the old expression? That's not quite how I saw it playing out in my head. You know they didn't expect this at all. As you mentioned, went into the half with the lead. Losing the game is one thing. Getting shut out in the second half, that's a surprise.
So for L.A.,
they get a critical 10th win on the year with one game left.